मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द हिस्ट्री चैप्टर द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन एंड सो वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द अबॉलिशन ऑफ स्लेवरी. वी वर ऑलरेडी टॉकिंग अबाउट इट. पेज 21, ओपन टू पेज 21 इन योर बुक्स, द अबॉलिशन ऑफ स्लेवरी. एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड दैट वन ऑफ द मोस्ट रेवोल्यूशनरी रिफॉर्म्स दैट वर टेकन बाय द जैकोबिन रेजिम फॉर द अबॉलिशन ऑफ स्लेवरी. एंड the French, the colonies in the Caribbean, so they had their colonies in the Caribbean, they have Martinique, Guadeloupe and Saint Domingo. Now these colonies in the Caribbean, now they were important suppliers of goods like tobacco, indigo, sugar and coffee, which were needed by the Europeans. But the Europeans did not wanted to go and work, to go to such far off lands, unfamiliar lands, they did not wanted to go there. And so as a result, there was a shortage of labor on these plantations in the Caribbean colonies. Now, how to go about it? What to do about this shortage of labor? Now, this was met by a triangular slave trade. Why triangular? Because it was between Europe, Africa and America. Now this slave trade, it began in the 17th century, and so French merchants, they sailed because they had their colonies, the French had their colonies in the Caribbean and they wanted laborers there. The people, Europeans, they were not willing to go and work there, so they wanted laborers there. So the French merchants, they sailed from the ports of Bordeaux and Nantes, and then they went to Africa. So from Europe they went down to Africa, and there they bought slaves from the local chiefs. They branded them, the slaves were branded with a hot metal, a mark was put on their body to distinguish themselves, to tell that they were slaves and not free men. And then they were shackled, means they were put in chains, and they were tightly packed in ships for a 3 month long voyage. Means it took 3 months for the ship to reach from Africa to the Caribbean islands. Where are the Caribbean islands? That day I told you. Yes, anyone remembers where are the Caribbean islands? Yes, ninth day.
Martinique.
Caribbean islands.
Yes,
Martinique.
No one? Okay, so we have the North America and the South America. So east of Central America, east of Mexico, Mexico is the lowest part of North America. So east of Mexico and north of South America, so South America is down, so north of South America, there you have the Caribbean Sea and there you have the Caribbean Islands. And so triangular slave trade, merchants from the ports of Bordeaux and Nantes, they went down to Africa, took the slaves from there and sent them to the plantation owners in the Caribbean, in the Caribbean islands. Okay, so now they were here. Once they were at the Caribbean islands, they were sold to the plantation owners. And this slave trade, it made possible to meet the growing demand for coffee, indigo and sugar in the European market, because there was a great demand. There was not enough supply in their own country, so they could get it from their colonies in the Caribbean. And port cities like Bordeaux and Nantes, they owned their prosperity to this slave trade. Because of the slave trade, they had made so much money. Now, throughout the 18th century, not much was said against this slave trade or the slavery in France. And though the National Assembly, they held long debates that whether the rights of man and citizen, it should be extended to all French subjects, means to all French subjects, included the slaves also. But they did not pass any law because they were afraid of the opposition of the merchants, big businessmen and merchants and traders, because the incomes of these big businessmen, merchants and traders, it depended on the slave trade. So they did not pass any law because they were afraid that they will lose the support of these big businessmen and these merchants and traders. And so finally, it was a convention in 1794, and they passed the law to free all slaves in all French overseas possessions, means in all the French colonies, overseas colonies also. In 1794, the convention, it passed the law to free all slaves. But this, you know, it turned out to be a short-term measure. Why short-term measure? Because 10 years later, Napoleon Bonaparte, you know, he again reintroduced, so when he ascended the throne, he again reintroduced slavery. And, you know, plantation owners, they thought that it was their right to enslave African Negroes. Now, Negro, see, it is a derogatory term. Alright, it is a term which is not in use now much, and it is a derogatory term. It is used for the local people, the native people of Africa. And so, you know, these plantation owners, they thought that it was their right. They can enslave these African Negroes, so they can enslave them for their own benefit or for their own profit. And slavery was finally abolished in French colonies in 1848. So it was, you know, in 1794, slavery was banned, means all slaves were free. But 10 years later, again in 2004, when he ascended the throne, so again slavery was reintroduced, and finally it was abolished in French colonies in 1848. Okay. So now we turn to the last topic here of our chapter, the revolution and everyday life. You all are able to hear me? Okay. Now, can politics or the way a country is governed or the politics of the country, can it change the clothes that people wear or the language that people speak or the books that the people read? Now, the answer to this question is that the years following 1789 in France, they saw many changes in the lives of men, women and children, and the revolutionary governments during this time, you know, they took it as their work, as their task, to pass laws so as to translate the ideals of liberty. You know, we have already done that the ideals that came from the French Revolution was liberty, equality before law and fraternity. Now, you know, common people, illiterate people, how can they be taught about these things? How can these terms be explained to them? So the revolutionary governments, they took it upon themselves to translate these ideals into laws so that everyone would be able to enjoy freedom, liberty and equality. Now, one important law that came into effect after the storming of the prison Bastille, now that was the abolition of censorship. Now, you know what happened in the old regime in France? Everything that was written, so all written material, and not only all written material but cultural activities also, and that means processions, plays, and you know, festive processions, everything, and so books, newspapers, plays, now all this could only be published, or even the plays and all, they could only be performed after they had been approved by the censors of the king. So the king, they had their censors, and after it has been sent approved by the censors, then only the books can be published, or newspapers could be published, or the plays could be performed. Now, after the Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen, now this declaration said that the people had freedom of speech and the freedom of expression, means they can speak their views and they can speak their mind, and they can also express it. Now, the writing, plays, poetry and newspaper, and you know, even drawings, paintings, all these are expressions. So now people had freedom to speak and also to express. And so, you know, newspapers, pamphlets, books, painted pictures, now all, you know, they came to be printed in large numbers and they flooded the towns of France. And from the towns, they went to the countryside also. And these newspapers, these books, the pamphlets, you know, they all described and they discussed about the events which were taking place in France and in these revolutionary years and the changes that were taking place in France. And so, you know, they all talked about that. Now we had the freedom of the press. So freedom of the press means that everyone is free to publish their views. So now if I am able to publish my view, someone who is against my view, that person is also free to publish their views. So, you know, each side, they sought to convince the others that what they are standing for is correct. And now these plays, songs and festive processions, they large number of people came to see them. And you know, this was one way, these plays and processions and songs, this was one way through which the illiterate people, they can also come to understand the meaning of these new ideas, the meaning of liberty, equality, justice that the French philosophers were talking about. So, you know, the common people, the illiterate people can understand the concepts through these plays and songs. And whereas the writings, only a handful of educated people can read and understand. And so this was so much popular and people came in large numbers to see them. And so this, you know, plays and novels and plays and songs and processions, they were used to tell the people the concept and the meaning of these ideals of liberty, equality, fraternity, justice and all. Okay. Now, in 1804, Napoleon Bonaparte, he crowned himself as the Emperor of France. And so, you know, when he crowned himself Emperor of France, that means France returned to monarchy. And after that, you know, he set out to win over the neighboring European countries. And he defeated the various dynasties and he created kingdoms in many places in Europe. And there, you know, he placed members of his own family as rulers. Now, Napoleon, he thought himself to be, you know, he saw his role that he was a modernizer of Europe. He has come to modernize Europe. So he saw his role as a modernizer of Europe. He introduced many reforms also and many good ones, many there which are still followed in France. So he introduced laws such as protection of private property, that no one can violate private property, and even the state, neither the clergy, nobility, no one can take away your property. So he passed laws such as protection of private property, a uniform system of weights and measures, and then which was provided by the decimal system. So all this, and you know, in addition to that, he passed many laws which you will study more in class 10th, that he did away with the privileges which were based on birth. If you remember, we started the chapter with the French society being divided into three estates, and the people of the first and the second estate, they had all the privileges. So he did away with the privileges which was based on birth, and he established equality before law. He now had the right to, means right to property was for all. Earlier, only people of the first estate and the second estate, and only some people of the third, richer people of the third estate, were entitled to property. But now, you know, everyone was entitled. They had a right to property. Feudal system under him was abolished, and transport system, communication, they were all improved. Uniform laws were established under him, standardized weights and measures, so, and a common national currency. All these reforms were brought about by Napoleon. Now, initially, many people saw Napoleon to be, as a liberator, a person who has come to bring about freedom for the people. But soon after some time, you know, his armies came to be viewed everywhere as invading force, means, you know, which you do not want. So they came as invaders, and they came to be seen as invaders and not as a liberator. And now finally, he was defeated at Waterloo in 1815, and many of his measures that carried on these ideas of fraternity, of liberty and modern laws, they had a great impact on a large part of Europe long after Napoleon was gone. So even long after Napoleon was gone, the laws and these modern laws and reforms that he brought about had a great impact on Europe. And the ideas of liberty, democratic rights, equality, fraternity, now these are the most important legacy of the French Revolution, and these ideals, they spread from France to the rest of Europe during the 19th century. And so in many places in the rest of Europe also, feudalism was abolished, and from there it reached to different countries also, it reached to colonies also. So colonized people, they also worked upon the idea of freedom from bondage into independence in their own ways, in their own states, so that they can also create sovereign nation states in their country. And Tipu Sultan and Raja Ram Mohan Roy, they are examples of two individuals who responded to these ideas which were coming from revolutionary France. Okay, so that was the chapter. Have you all understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so today I will make you mark.
Yes, ma'am.
Mark a few questions. You can write this in the book itself, and the answer you will find on that page only. So, page number 4. If you have a look at page number 4. So, first paragraph here. You can have few questions from this first paragraph. Like, who was Louis XVI? Alright. Who was Louis XVI? And when did he ascend the throne? What was the name of his queen? Okay. One more question. Why did Louis XVI? Why did Louis XVI? Found the treasury empty when he ascended the throne. Why did Louis XVI found the treasury empty when he ascended the throne? This answer you will get here in the first paragraph. I have already done that with you when we were doing the chapter. So this you will get from the first paragraph only. See, from the third line, upon his accession, the new king found an empty treasury, and thereafter they had given the reasons why the treasury was empty. Okay. Then second paragraph. The system of estates in French society. What was the system of estates in French society? And this you will know from this figure two also, that it was divided. You have to write in this that the French society was divided into three estates, the first, the second and the third, and which all people came into the different states. Then you also have to write from this paragraph that who had to pay the taxes and all that. Who had to pay the taxes and who were exempted from paying the taxes. All this you will get from the second paragraph. Then from the third paragraph, or you have new words in the box also. So you need to learn that also, the meaning of livre, clergy, tithe, what was tithe, many times you are asked that for 1 mark questions. What was tithe, so you need to know. Then next page, subsistence crisis. So many times we ask for 1 mark questions, what do you understand by subsistence crisis? So this is that in the box. And now this paragraph here on page 5, you can write the question here. What led to subsistence crisis. What led to subsistence crisis? In the old regime, what led to subsistence crisis in the old regime? So you need to write about this whole paragraph, that the population, it increased, the food grains, they could not keep pace with the growing population, so rises of food grains, they rose. So all this you need to write in that. Okay, next page. What role did the middle classes play during French Revolution? What role did the middle classes play during the French Revolution? What role did the middle classes play during the French Revolution? All right, so this you will get in the second paragraph here. All right, that the 18th century it witnessed the emergence of the social groups. Okay, from this paragraph, and then from this paragraph you have one more question. Okay, the role of philosophers. What was the role of philosophers in the French Revolution? So in this particular answer, you need to mention all the three philosophers which are mentioned here. All right, you need to mention their books and also what they have written about in their books. So all that you need to write about the philosophers for this particular question. Okay, turn the page. Page 8, first paragraph. What was a States General? So sometimes for a 1 mark question you get, what was a States General? So you have this in this particular paragraph, that the States General was a political body to which the three estates and their representatives. Okay, in the third paragraph, for that you can write, why did the people of the third estate walked out of the Estates General Assembly? Why did the people of the third estate walked out of the Estates General Assembly? So from this particular paragraph, third paragraph, you will get the answer. Then from the fourth paragraph, who were the leaders of the third estate? So you in this paragraph you will know, you will study about Mirabeau and Abbesses. And then sometimes you are also asked that who was Mirabeau, who was Abbesses. So all that you will get from this particular paragraph. So who was Abbesses also you will get. Write down who was Abbesses, one question. Who was Mirabeau, another question. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पेज नंबर 9 द फर्स्ट न्यू पैराग्राफ हियर फॉर दैट वन व्हाइल द नेशनल असेंबली वाज बिजी एट वर्साय फॉर दिस राइट डाउन व्हाई डिड द एजिटेटेड क्राउड्स व्हाई डिड द एजिटेटेड क्राउड्स और एंग्री क्राउड stormed the Bastille. Why did the agitated crowd storm Bastille? Bastille. Why did the agitated crowd storm Bastille? Okay. Then from the corner, you need to know what is a chateau. Chateau is given here. And the plural is chateaus. Plural is pronounced as chateaus and the singular is chateau. So chateau and manor is given there. That also you need to know. Then turn the page. So this first paragraph also is important. You need to know what is written in this paragraph, that the powers were divided now. And from the second paragraph here, you need to know who were active citizens and who were passive citizens. Write down the question, differentiate between active and passive citizens. Differentiate between active and passive citizens.
Yes, ma'am. Written.
Okay, next, page 11. Here you can write the importance. What was the importance of the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen? What was the importance of the Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen? What was the importance of the Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen? So this particular paragraph here tells why it was so important. And then you need to also at least know 5 points from the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen, at least 5 points. Then, you know, you can't leave anything. So whatever is given in the boxes, in the figures, under the illustrations, the sources, you need to know everything there. So for today, we will stop here. And then tomorrow, we'll do the rest of the questions. When we meet tomorrow,
ma'am, please repeat. Ma'am, please repeat all the questions.
Please repeat
all the questions.
I am not able to hear, beta. All the questions.
Ma'am, please. Yes, ma'am.
Beta, that you can hear from the recording. I will send you the recording, and from there you can listen. All right. You can check.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Because repeating all would take a lot of time.